put it across few points here. Madam Speaker, we have three sectors which are main in our country, like farming, weaving and business sectors. In these three sectors, out of these, like farming is a major, where most of the farmers, 60% of in our country farmers are dependent on farming community, where entire state, in almost all our states are demanding that these farmers should be rescued from the loan waiver by giving a loan, you know, farming loan, by waiving the farm loans. And not only that, by supporting, giving the minimum support price to the crops. What's happening, though we are mentioned, we are saying that the government is supporting with the minimum support price, but we are unable to implement that to all farmers. So majority of these people, especially in my constituency, onion and tomato, these farmers, whoever is doing these, you know, coming up with these crops, they're unable to get the transport prices also. Due to that, they're forced to throw the crops on the main roads. So they're like forced to commit suicides. So we, if we can think about these things, we can rescue the farmers by from committing suicides. So we have to seriously and sincerely think about this community. Another thing, like Handloom, sir, this is the major issue. And one thing, which is the GST, due to the GST, Handloom is into a real problem. The major cause is all these years, like there was 0% tax. Now, the 5% tax on a Handloom, which has been imposed on that. So these cost of the product, which has become more expensive than the power looms. So here again, like power looms, like the cheap, the material cost is cheaper and Handloom cost is expensive. Whereas again, we said less than 1,000 rupees is 5% tax on textile and more than 1,000 rupees is 12%. Again, here, like in everywhere, the Handloom product is Handloom people are really suffering with these kind of a taxation. Not only this, sir, like Handloom people, like, you know, unless they are form a cluster or some kind of forming, you know, they have to form a group of people, then only they can go for a GST. If they are not individually, they are unable to go for a GST, so they are losing the livelihood of doing their own that farming, the Handloom on their own. Otherwise, all these days, the Handloom people, like, you know, one or two families were doing with their own and they were able to sell in the market. Due to the GST, they are unable to do this and they are unable to go for a GST. And GST has become very complicated for those people. They are unable to understand what is the procedure and formalities and how to go about it. This is also, we need to seriously think about this, sir. Another thing, business community. Whereas like a minimum and small and medium and entrepreneurs, especially ma'am, these people, when they are going for the loans, banks are straightforward, they're refusing to give the loans due to the economic conditions of the banks also and bad performance of the banks also. They're not implementing not even the mudra loans. They're refusing the schemes of a government what they're supposed to give the loans also. These are the things, the 3 points, sir.
Yes.
Where the Indian economy completely depended on these three sectors. Okay. Ma'am, finally, I would like to mention one thing, especially which has come to our state. Our state is a newly formed state, whereas, like, you know, AP Reorganization Act, all these being promised and whatever the promises have been made on the floor of the house, none has been implemented. Our state really needs the financial support. I request the finance minister to support the state, whereas it's like, you know, Polavaram project and Vizag's railway zone and Kadapa steel factories. And there are many of these 18 yes. to 19 points of these, ma'am. I request the government to seriously and sincerely look into this and help the state government AP by supporting the finance support, by giving the finance support. Thank you, ma'am.
Prem Singh Chandu Manjaroji.